Carolyn Doobie here. What's the play for today? Today it has to do with gift giving. Now, if you've ever looked around on Pinterest, you might have seen some of those exquisitely wrapped packages, the very lengthy, complex tutorials for how to wrap a package that would make Martha Stewart envious. Yeah, the kind that take a couple of hours. Yeah, this isn't like that. That's not the kind of thing that I do, because I'm giving a gift card. Now, don't judge me for giving a gift card. I think this person actually really wants the gift card so that they can pick out what they want, but I don't want to just give them a plain old gift card. I want to put some extra something to it, a little special touch, but I really don't want to spend 2 to 3 hours doing it. So I'm going to share with you in this video a quick way that you can take any square piece of anything and make a quick gift card holder. Now, what I'm going to use for it are one of my sparks of artspiration, but you can use anything for it, including art that you've made. Now, if you're not familiar with what Sparks of Artspiration are, they are printables. They come in my newsletter every week. There's a different one, and you can save them on your computer and then print them out whenever you want to use them. And if you haven't gotten this one in my last newsletter, if you didn't get this one, never fear. There's a link down below for you can jump on it and get this one emailed to you right away. Well, I'm going to start by cutting out my spark, and it's approximately 7.5 inches. Nothing about this is precise, so something about this size will work. And I'm just using regular old copy paper here that I just printed off on my computer. I'm going to fold it in half, and then I'm going to use a glue stick, and I'm going to glue the two sides together. So now my paper has magically become double-sided. So I'm going to create the pocket now where it's going to go, and how wide will it be? This is precision at its finest. I'm going to put it about a finger from the edge. Then I'm going to use the edge of the card to give me a nice line to fold it on. And yeah, if you figured out it's not really that precise here, you just need to have some wiggle room there. It needs to be wider than the card. Now the next thing you need to do is make the flap for that side. So I need just a little itty bitty flap, and that's where the card is so very handy. It makes it really easy to get that straight line on that little bit if you're using the card there. Now the tricky part is to fold the other side of it. Now how am I going to mark that? Well, I am going to use a very fancy tool called the fingernail, and I'm going to make an indentation in the paper there. And it's very hard for you to see, but I can see it. And what I'm going to do is that's where I'm going to fold. I'm going to start by putting a crease in there with my fingernail, and then I'm going to be able to fold it the rest of the way down. But what happens if that fold isn't perfect? Well, guess what? Absolutely nothing. It's just a matter of straightening back out there. I mean, after all, this is paper. And now that I've got the folds the way I want them, now it's time to do a little trimming, because that's one huge flap over there. I do not need a big flap like that. I just need a little one like the other side, so I cut off the excess. So now I've got all the hard part done here, and it's time to add the adhesive. Now, I've got to decide what the top and the bottom is. And the part where the fold is, I'm going to call that one the top, because it's going to look the neatest and tidiest. And I'm going to put glue here along one side and across the entire bottom. And I just want to put a thin little bit of glue. I don't need a lot there, because I'm still going to need my gift card to fit in there. So if I put too much glue, it's not going to fit. So now I've got the top is where the fold is. I'm going to slide in my card to make sure it fits, because, well, it's always good to double check myself since I didn't measure a single thing here. And now I'm going to put a little punch here using a circle punch. This one's a 3/4 inch punch, I believe. And I'm just going to cut that half circle out. Now, could I have cut that with scissors? Absolutely, I could have. I just cut really, really junky circles, so that's why I'll use a punch for that. So now it's a win-win. They're getting the gift card so they can go pick out what they want, and I'm giving a gift that has some thought in it, has some color and creativity, but didn't take me hours to do. Well, thanks so much for joining me for today's play. And remember, you can get this printout as well as new Sparks of Artspiration every week in your inbox by heading over to acolorfuljourney.com and getting signed up for my newsletter. Thanks so much for letting me be a part of your colorful journey.